So obviously, this is going to be riddled with spoilers. So if you're not into that, maybe click away and watch the rest of the season of Supernatural
Rest of the
and the
series.
series finale, because that's it'll ruin everything. So just click off now, come back when you're done, and enjoy us. So we wanted to do a reaction, like a live reaction to the last episode, but we were both incredibly sick. We have the virus that you're not allowed to name on YouTube. So,
Really? You can't?
no, you can't. So,
The virus that shall not be
yeah,
named.
we had the Voldemort and we didn't really feel up to filming anything, even shortly after watching the season and series finale. So, we figured we'd do it now and kind of just give like a rundown of why we loved Supernatural so much and our thoughts on how they ended everything, some of our favorite moments. So it's really hard to be so invested in something and then know that someday it's going to end, but then when it finally ends, you're just so heartbroken, you know?
It's the fact is that is that this TV show has significant ties to our relationship. This was like the first this is like the first thing we did together as like a couple consistently. I got her into the show. I've been watching the show for 15 years since first episode, since it used to air after Smallville on CW way back in the day. And when we first started dating, I told her about this show, and she's like, and I, brought her like the first season, and like I forget what season you picked it up on, but we literally, like I was like, if you really like the show, it airs every Thursday at this time, but you got to catch up. So we like binge watched a bunch of seasons and got her caught up, and then we like live watched it up until season 15, where we would just watch it like the weekend after on the CW app. And it's like it's been like our show. I mean, we have like, where's the camera? Like we have matching Supernatural tattoos that we got together. Hers is on her back. But it's this show has had so many ties to our relationship. Like we made the joke. I'm like, well, now that's over, I guess we're getting divorced.
Well, eh,
I was
you hit a
like,
good run too, I guess.
what do we got? What do we got now? But no, we've been so in tie and we've been so in tied into this show that it was just, it's you hate to see it end. Just like everybody's favorite show, Game of Thrones. Everybody hated to see that end, but I think we got a good ending. I like the way the show ended. So major spoiler alerts, we're gonna talk about how the whole series ended right now. So what did you like about the finale?
I liked that they didn't like. So Supernatural has a really big track record of just ripping your heart out and then trying to make it up to you, like, you know what I mean?
Like when they killed Bobby Singer.
Yeah. Or, you know, when they killed any of the favorite characters off. And you've seen these characters die over and over and over again, but knowing that this is the last episode, there's no, you know, demon at a crossroads that they can make a deal with, and they're just finally, you know, they have free will and everything like that. And then when, you know, your favorite characters just start dropping off, you realize, like, this is it. And I like that they didn't, you know, do the thing that they've kept doing how many seasons, just bringing them back over and over and over again. It was like, no, guys, this is it. This is real, which I don't know. It hurt, but it was a really, you know, it tied up all the loose ends, I feel like. I like that in the final scene with Dean, you know, he's obviously the one that meets his untimely death in a really, like, not even, you know,
In
having his
basic
yeah,
way,
not even like having his heart ripped out or anything. It's
I
like an
called it.
accident.
I called it too
I
when I
knew it.
saw, as soon as I saw the
As
spike,
soon
I
as
was
you
like,
saw it sticking out, you're like, oh
damn
no,
it.
oh no, oh my God. And he's just on it, and it's not even like a Dean and Sam moment. It's the actors, because they're like best friends. And I think once it, you know, really hit them, like, this is the last scene we're gonna do, it was like not even so much it hurt to see, you know, two brothers being separated, but it's like these best friends that have been working together for how long, it really, like, their true emotions really shined through.
They were, and it was groomsmen.
Painful.
They were groomsmen in each other's weddings, who they both married actresses from the show, which is awesome.
Yeah.
But they were groomsmen in each other's weddings. Like, they said for 15 years they played brothers on screen, and they, like, became brothers in real life. Like, they're close, like, brothers now. And it's just like, you know, when Jensen says the line, "always keep fighting," which is a nod to Jared's charity to help people with mental health issues, you know, like, that's a real moment between two people who are really good friends, and they're getting ready to go and do two separate things. Jensen's gonna go be on The Boys on Amazon Prime. I think he's Soldier Boy, which was funny when I first read it. I was like, Soldier Boy? Superman, that hoe. And then Jensen's going to play, you know, Walker, Texas Ranger in the reboot.
I can't take that seriously.
I'm gonna look at him in the Western attire and always call back to the episode where Dean goes back in time to meet Samuel Colt, and that's the only thing I'm gonna be able to think of now. But I mean, it's one of those things where it's just like, you know, it was such a great scene too, but it was like, it ripped your heart out.
Yeah, we were both on the couch, just
tears,
crying.
I was just like, oh, I didn't want all these emotions.
The whole, like, a lot of people have said, even the actors themselves, the episode before the last episode is really, like, that's the finale. And then this one, you know,
is the series finale.
Yeah.
Yeah, though the episode 19 is the season finale for season 15, and they said episode 20 is the series finale.
It was so hard. But I feel like they did do a really good job, you know, with the pandemic, it screwed up everything with filming. They wanted the last episode to have everyone in it, but in reality they can't do that with, you know,
because
having to quarantine and
Jeffrey Dean Morgan is doing The Walking Dead, so they said it was unfair to a lot of people who are working on other things to make them come up here quarantine for 2 weeks in Vancouver and then shoot one scene, then have to fly back to the U.S., quarantine for another 2 weeks. That's 4 weeks away from their family, away from other projects they're working
and
on.
And it's putting them at unnecessary risk.
Yeah, and they said, you know, the finale was originally supposed to be when Dean's driving, when Dean's in heaven and he's driving, he's supposed to see people from the show. Garth and a lot of the, you know, Sue and Joe and, you know, like, see a lot of people throughout, like, the entire show. They were going to bring back a lot of people, and that's who he was going to see until he ends up on the bridge and yada yada yada. And, you know, they said this was kind of a happy accident because the show ended the way it began, just Sam and Dean and the car on a bridge.
Because if
you remember, the first episode was the Lady in White, where they were on the bridge together. So they said it's nice how it kind of came full circle. And if you see what they're wearing very similar clothes to what they wore in the pilot, which was a nice little ode too.
Yeah.
The thing, one of my favorite things from the finale is the song, the remake of Carry On Wayward Son by Baloney, I believe is their group's name. I talked to them on YouTube briefly, which was really, really cool to talk to them. They made that song like over a year ago, and they made it for Supernatural because they're huge fans. And they were literally like, you know, when they put out the song a year ago, people were like, oh, this would be great in Supernatural. They're like, yeah, we're huge fans. Let's try to get it to them. And apparently people were like, you know, tweeting this at Jensen and Jared and Robert Singer and Misha Collins. And finally somebody brought it to them and they were like, we love this. So they, because, you know, in every every season finale, Carry On Wayward Son has been in every season finale.
Yeah, it's like the journey so far, mm-hmm. and then your heart just sinks.
I also read a really great thing, is that somebody had that preloaded in the car and didn't tell Jensen, so when he turns on the car and the song starts playing, that was completely ad-libbed. It was his natural reaction. I love this song. Which is, you know, I love that song. Was in, we used that song on our wedding because of what this show means to us. Mm-hmm. So it was just, I thought it was just perfect. I thought it was great.
Can we talk about Castiel?
Oh.
That, I knew it was coming. I knew it was coming.
I forgot about it.
I was not prepared for it because I love that character so much. I love that actor so much.
Oh, and Misha Collins is great.
Like, literally, the self-sacrifice and the moment of him, like, fully being joyful and happy destroyed me.
I forgot about the deal he made with the Empty, that when he finally achieves happiness, that he would, that the Empty would come and get him. So it's like this whole bittersweet moment where he, and you know, he completely changes Dean in that moment.
Yeah.
Where he tells him that, you think you just kill people, but you save people and you're a good person. And I think Dean needed to hear him say that.
He was so consumed with revenge at that point. Uh-huh. I feel like there wouldn't have been anything else that would have made him react differently.
Yeah, and they would have probably killed Chuck had Cass not said that. But the great thing, I love that. And then the great thing was the nod when Dean gets into heaven and Bobby's like, well, Cass helped.
And they talked about Jack.
Mm-hmm.
I love Jack.
Jack was a surprisingly good character.
He had a lot of
annoying moments.
There was a lot of arc to his character where you were just like, oh, he is bad, like, to the core. Mm-hmm. That's it. But then you really have to take a step back and be like, well, he's really, like, he's a child. He's just a, like, child in a grown-up body that has no idea what he's doing,
like, when
and
they,
has emotions, and he didn't do that to Mary on purpose
when he nuked Mary Winchester.
He's just, yeah, who isn't like that when they're a teenager?
Yeah. Who doesn't nuke people when they're a teenager? But yeah, like, it's the whole finality of it is you get the ultimate happy ending. Dean, who has always said he's going to die hunting. That's his destiny. Dean gets the end he wanted. And then Sam, the thing with Sam, though, is when you see his, with freaking Dean. Oh. You see the mom in the background. Is it the deaf girl?
I didn't even look at
her. You can't see her, but she's got the same build and the same long brown hair as the deaf girl. And I like to think they
Eileen,
ended up together.
Don't call her
I couldn't
deaf.
Remember her
That's
name.
That's rude.
So I like to think him and Eileen ended up together.
Yeah.
And then
One thing I gotta say, though, whoever did the age makeup on Jared Padalecki, you done did that boy dirty.
It was so bad.
That was not good. And I don't know if that was, like, practical age makeup or they tried to do it with CGI, but it was just,
you failed.
It wasn't good.
You could have used a Snapchat filter and it would have looked better.
I mean, like, it looked at one point like they just put a wig on him. And he was acting all frail when he's in the Impala.
That was such a great moment, though, when he holds on to the steering wheel.
I couldn't focus on the moment because I was just like, why does he look like that? That's
like when he's holding on to the steering wheel and they transition to Dean's driving with his hands in the same spot. Oh.
And why did Sam show up to heaven looking young again when he died a frail old man? Conspiracy.
No, it's because
it's a little suspicious.
It's because you go to heaven and you get to be the, you know, Dean didn't go there with a freaking stake through his back and that's how he died.
Well, no, but he went there the same age as when he died, is what I mean.
Yeah, but Sam went there and he reverted back to the age he wanted to be.
Why wouldn't he revert back to, like, way younger?
No, because he was Moose back then.
He's still Moose. He'll go, he'd revert back to being Dean from Gilmore Girls.
But yeah, and that's like the really cool thing. The thing that gives people hope for anything beyond this is Netflix actually bought Supernatural. They bought the rights to Supernatural. That's why the season finale now aired on Netflix, I think like a week or two after it aired on CW and aired on live television, because Netflix actually bought the rights to the Supernatural franchise. And there's been talks of, you know, like Jensen and Jared have, and me and Misha have all said that they'd be okay with doing a small reboot kind of thing like they did with Gilmore Girls. So, you know, and Jared has a connection to that show too, and he said that he would be, that they would all be okay with that. We won't get it on CW because CW never lets an actor be a main character in two different shows at the same time. That's why Supernatural had to end before Walker, Texas Ranger could begin.
Because everyone's just raring to watch Walker, Texas Ranger. I can't wait.
I say it more as that's why they held Walker, Texas Ranger until after Supernatural was done.
And Jared kept alluding in a bunch of interviews that we watched that it's not goodbye, it's see you later. Yeah, so
it's because I really think Netflix is going to bring something back where I would love to see them bring it back where everybody's in heaven and it's just kind of like this, you know how Gilmore Girls did like the year thing. It could be a couple of episodes of Dean and Sam going around heaven talking to other people and yada yada yada, and it ends with them seeing Cass. But Cass is in like full angel form though, which would be awesome.
Ew.
I'm sick too. But yeah, that's all right. So name some of your, we're gonna go over like favorite moments from the entire series. We're gonna go the whole series. I know you and I both have a same favorite moment, which is when Dean has ghost sickness, and he is and he's going up to the locker. And Sam opens it, and the cat jumps out, and Dean's just like, ah,
for like way too long.
He's like,
and Sam's just like,
that was scary. That is probably one of my favorite, like, funny moments. That and pudding.
The pudding one, yeah.
The pudding one where they're in the mental institution pretending to be patients, and the orderly nurse catches them, and Dean just pulls down his pants and goes, pudding!
Ugh. Castiel, hey, ass butt.
Hey, oh my god.
Because not only does that, you know, exclamation disarm you mentally, but, like,
he does
what?
It
and then he Molotovs him.
Yeah, he Molotov cocktails. He Molotov cocktails Michael with a freaking holy oil Molotov cocktail, which is great.
Which, like, if you don't use that in your day-to-day life, you're really missing a good opportunity. Because if someone cuts you off in traffic and you're like, hey, ass butt, and they're like,
What?
Or if they like Supernatural, they're like, yeah, and you're like, no, you cut me off. I'm still mad at you.
Probably all the Jensen Ackles singing.
Oh my god, the bloopers are gold.
The Eye of the Tiger from the episode Yellow Fever.
I still don't think that's what it's called.
It's called that. I swear to God, it's called that.
Sounds racist.
And the I'm all out of love.
Yeah, with the piece of shit car.
Oh my god.
The outtake for that is pure gold, and I love it so much because, like, I really hate to admit how much I like that song, and then just to see him in character singing it, and Jared Padalecki's just reacting very awkwardly to it, like, ooh, because it's cringe, 100%.
I'd like to show you here the episode that aired October 23rd, 2008, called Yellow Fever.
Sam and Dean discover
a Colorado small town's dark secret as a way people fall prey to ghost sickness. I was right.
They should have just called it Ghost Fever.
Yeah, like him singing is great. I mean, if you've never watched the bloopers and outtakes from this show, take a day, because it's gonna take a day.
And I feel like you watch this series, like you watch each season, and the way they end it will cripple you emotionally. So you need to watch the bloopers to laugh so you can go to sleep.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they have the entire series for pilot to finale on Netflix now. And we started rewatching it just kind of as like what we usually do with The Office. You know, it plays in the background while we're both on TikTok, sending each other TikToks while we sit on the couch next to each other. Because it's so hard to hand your phone over to the other person. But, yeah, we started watching the background, and it's just like you get to, if you're like us and you've watched this all 15 seasons beginning to end, go back and start it over. It's worth it. I got to see him kill Yellow Eyes again. You know, got to see, you know, when John crawled out of hell to grab the Yellow Eye demon, and a lot of really fun moments, a lot of really good moments from the seasons. You get to
when Castiel drug Dean out of hell.
Mm-hmm. I reached down and pulled you out of perdition. That's the other thing. When Castiel puts his hand on Dean, his bloody handprint is literally in the same spot as the scar was. So I actually saw somebody at a Supernatural convention who actually has that as a tattoo. I was like, oh, you're hardcore, buddy. I'd also like to note, for the record, I had my anti-demonic possession symbol tattoo on my arm before Sam's kid did. Okay? I'd like to note that for the record. Somebody had pointed that out to me. So
you did it before it was cool?
I did it before it was cool.
What was your least favorite main character?
Rufus.
Really?
Yeah,
I liked Rufus.
I wasn't ever really a big Rufus fan. It's not that I didn't like him. It's that I really liked all the other main characters. Actually, probably Mary Winchester.
That's my pick.
I wasn't really a big fan of hers. I don't really feel like she brought anything. She's kind of a shitty character, to be honest. But probably her. Who's your favorite character?
My favorite character, I just heard the cat squeak in the background.
All right, fine. I will
go to go either with Castiel.
That's who I thought you were gonna say.
Or Crowley.
Oh, love me some Crowley.
Oh, I miss him. I miss that character on the show.
Oh my god.
And his send-off broke our hearts.
Mm-hmm. The goodbye boys.
Mm-hmm.
Every other time it was hello boys. That was so... Let's talk... My favorite character is Dean. Just because, you know, the whole classical hairband metal... Hairband rock, classic rock, muscle car, bacon cheeseburgers... I love that.
How awkward Castiel is.
And I love me some pie. I love pie. But...
Oh, Lucifer was good, too.
Lucifer was great. Lucifer was... Let's talk about how well-written this show was.
Yeah.
This show was written very well. It was casted... Amazingly casted. Good actors. Played great roles. And it was so good. It was so well written, so well casted. Like, I tell people, like, how can you not like this show?
They're probably not into, like, horror, and they think that's the entire aspect of the show. Yeah. Which, in, like, the latter seasons, there wasn't, like, a whole lot of horror element to it. Yeah, there wasn't a lot of monster hunting or anything.
Yeah, there wasn't a lot of gore. It was a lot of, like, storytelling.
They did finally do a whole episode about Baba Yaga, which I appreciated, but it wasn't a very good representation of Baba Yaga because it wasn't the stories that I was told when I was a child. But I was like, that was a pleasant surprise. It was nice that they did have, like, you know, a lot of the episodes in the end of this season were obviously like, how are we going to save the world? How are we going to get, you know, God and get him out of his freaking plan to destroy everything? But then they finally threw some of our good old monster hunting back into it, which was nice.
Yeah, because that's the way the show, that's the way the show started. It was all like 90% of the episode was, there's a new monster, find the monster, how do we kill it, and then sprinkled in there is a little bit of the underlying plot of we need to find Dad.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that, and that's what, you know, a lot of people, including, you know, my buddy Wayward Winchester on YouTube, says that his favorite seasons are the first three, because it was before the complex storytelling and everything like that. But
I had a hard time following some of the biblical stuff because I literally don't know anything or understand anything about Christianity.
I was raised Catholic,
so I had a lot of questions, and I was just like, well, I understand that God's an asshole, the angels are dicks, and, you know, all the demons and everything are bad, but I don't understand when they're like, oh, it's Michael, and I'm like, and? And then you would let me know what was going on. Patron saint of what?
He's the patron saint of military soldiers. That's why when I was deployed, I had a Saint Michael. I had a Saint Michael amulet that...
Your
was
mom
around
gave
my,
you?
That was around... No, actually, it was my grandmother's, God rest her soul. But I wore it in Afghanistan and Iraq as supposed to protect soldiers and everything like that. Mm-hmm. And I did it to appease my Catholic family.
I know that Gabriel was a trickster, but that's about all I knew.
Oh.
He was perfect!
The trickster was great.
And the fact that he just loved to screw with them relentlessly
was awesome.
And then when he came back and he was just batshit.
Mm-hmm.
That was
after he was
an adventure.
After he was held captive by Azazel. You didn't even know about the Four Knights of Hell either.
Ugh. I mean, I know stuff about hell. I just don't know anything about, like, you know.
But
hell's the interesting part. There's a lot of books about that.
But yeah, I mean, overall, I really like, you know, I really liked everything about this show. I found it by mistake. I was watching Smallville. Smallville had ended. I didn't change it. I actually couldn't find, I think if I remember it correctly, I couldn't find the remote. And then this new show came on. I was like, oh, I'll give this a shot. And then I watched it. I was like, oh, that's fucking awesome. And then I just kept watching it every week. And, you know, as they say, the rest is history.
I love how when people, you're in public and you find out that someone else likes Supernatural and they just become like 1,000 times cooler.
This is a beacon for Supernatural fans. I'll be in like the grocery store or I'll be like getting gas at Wawa or whatever. And somebody's like, Supernatural fan? I was like, hell yeah, I am. He's like, yo, then we'll start talking about Supernatural and stuff. And it's so funny. It's a complete strangers. And it's just, this is just like a beacon. Like, hey, I love Supernatural. Come talk to me about it. Because you know me, I can make friends anywhere.
Yeah. I was at the gym and I was doing arms and I felt someone, this was like, Diesel, you know, pre-pandemic, but I felt someone tap me on the arm and I was like, what the heck? Because like sometimes people are really nasty at the gym. And I pull my earbud out and this girl's like pointing at my back and then she's like pointing at her shoulder and she turns and she's got the anti-demonic possession tattoo and I was like, do you want to be friends?
Do you want to come over and watch Supernatural?
Like literally just like I'm sitting on the machine talking to her about the most recent episode and we're talking about angels and God and talking about how much God's a dick and there's people walking by like, what?
It's like, you don't understand.
What are you talking about?
God's an asshole and angels are dicks. But yeah, it's, you know, it's been a great ride. You know, 15 years for me. Like what? Like 10 for you?
Like, probably 9.
9? So it's...
We've been together...
9.
About 9.
9!
9!
It's been a little over 9. It's October.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just, it's...
It's sad, but I'm glad that we can keep rewatching it over and over again.
Yeah, I am grateful to Netflix for purchasing this so we can keep, because the CW will drop episodes off. You can only watch, you can only go back so far, but Netflix has it, and they're, hopefully, they own it, so it'll never leave.
And I mean, we could definitely watch episodes more comfortably now, knowing how it ends,
mm-hmm.
in the end. Like, it's okay that Sam doesn't have his soul right now, because we know what's going to happen.
It's okay that Sam got stabbed in the back, and it's okay that Dean sold his soul to have Sam back, and he's
It's okay die that Castiel, blah, 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 Leviathans. Like, it's okay.
Leviathans!
I can't stop quoting that. I'll yell that at work, and my coworkers who do not watch the show are just like...
What?
What?
I just, it's, you know, I'm very grateful to, you know, everybody that had something to do with the show. That show really, you know, honestly, there was points during the show where I was not in a good space in life. And this show was definitely a big, big outlet for me. It was a great way to escape. And I am forever grateful to the show for that. And, you know, also it's, you know, tied to such a great memory of us starting a date, and this was like our first this wasn't the first thing we watched together. The first two things we watched together were Hobo with a Shotgun and Human Centipede. Those are the first two movies we watched together.
I got to pick them.
Yeah. Learn that mistake fast. but we really like this really laid the groundwork for our relationship. This is like the first like thing, consistent thing we did together. And that's why it will forever be like one of the main things in our lives. I mean, we got tattoos to honor the show because that's how much the show has meant to us. So to see it end was a bittersweet moment, but I think it ended so good that I'm not even mad that it's over. And I've
Are you just disappointed?
I'm not mad. I am disappointed. But I don't believe this is the end. I think they're going to do something like I said, something like they did with the Gilmore Girls, like a throwback thing. And, you know, it'll be a couple of years down the road. And when it happens, we're going to be super excited. And hopefully we're still doing YouTube. And we'll probably do a review of that after we watch it.
And hopefully things simmer down out and we get to see them at a convention coming up.
Yeah.
That would be amazing.
I heard that they're going to do another Supernatural convention after COVID's, after the vaccine and everything like that, and when they can actually do conventions and people can be around each other again, and hopefully it's someplace on the East Coast that we can drive to, because I definitely want to go. So, I guess that's it.
I guess. We're going to go watch some, what do we have on right now, The Office?
Yeah.
Let's go watch some Office.
So, we're going to go be sad and watch The Office, but...
Those were our thoughts. Leave us some comments down below. How do you feel, you know, they did a good job of wrapping things up, or how would you have done it differently, you know, given the circumstances? Leave us some comments. Who was your favorite character? Do you have any scenes that pop into your mind that you love?
Do you have a favorite episode?
What's your favorite episode? Let us know. If you have not subscribed yet, please do. I'd love to have you. Leave a like if you did like the video. Or you can like the video if you like Misha Collins. Because, like, hello, he's awesome. Who doesn't like him?
He is awesome.
You can follow me on Facebook at Reanimator Reviews, Twitter and Instagram at Reanimator. You can find my solo as well as Reviews with the Groom on the Farsighted Network, posting them on iTunes. Thank you guys so much. I butchered that because it's been a while since I've actually reviewed anything. We pre-film a lot of stuff. But please don't forget to check out all of their awesome creators and content as well.
You can find me on Twitch under Repeat Ray Animator, where I play video games with a bunch of my dumb friends, but we have a good time. And it's usually a lot of fun stuff happens. You can find me on Twitter under Repeat Groom Ray. I don't tweet a lot of stuff other than stuff about my Twitch streams and random funny stuff, so I'm a good follow. But
I think you did that thing again.
What?
and go, but, yeah.
But, sorry. Yeah.
All right.
It's because I'm sad. I'm sad to see the end of the...
We're all sad. Sad
to see the end of my favorite show.
Like, this if is... 2020 couldn't get worse.
Yeah, I know.
We had to end Supernatural.
I blame this on...
That, nope.
The Voldemort. Virus. The Voldemort virus that we can't say the real name
you
for.
You totally said the real name before.
Oh, did I?
Yeah, you did.
Oh, well, we're getting banned.
No.
Okay, well, goodbye then.
Good to know you guys. Carry on.